Throwing the punches in close, glancing right hand got in. Venzi reaching down for something here with half a minute to go in this ninth round.
And Audia holding on there because he didn't like what was going on the inside. Decided that he would just hold on and wait to get outside again.
Time winding down in a very close ninth round. Giovanni Vivenzi and Barry Audia. We'll be right back.
Excitement of athletes.
This reflects what's been happening in the last couple of rounds. Barry Audia putting his combinations together.
And this is the 10th and final round. No knockdowns in this fight. I bet you Alex Wells is watching in Indiana and enjoying this fight.
I'll bet he is. And I wonder if he's got it scored the way I do. I've got Barry Audia ahead 5-3-1. It's unofficial. This fight could be dead even.
I've got it 5-4 for Audia. He has really come on big. Vivenzi digging down. A big, big 10th round. It's been quite a battle.
Early, Vivenzi came out doing the same things he's done against Kenny Whetstone, using his hand speed, his left hook to the body, but he stopped doing that in the middle round, but now he knows it's desperation time. Yeah. He is going after Barry Audia.
Audia with a good job of tying him up. The prediction from the Vivenzi camp, from trainer Carmen Graziano, and from Vivenzi himself, was a knockout in 7 or less. Obviously, Barry Audia has not let that happen.
The style of the two fighters and of their two camps, very different. But Barry Audia has shown some quiet confidence tonight.
Audia has not hurt Vivenzi. He has certainly frustrated him.
I agree. I think Vivenzi had Audia stunned early in the fight.
And again, an off-balance Vivenzi falls into the ropes. No knockdown.
Vivenzi's been lunging with the right hand. Carmen Graziano's been yelling at him the whole time. He's stepping before he punches. Graziano wants him to step as he punches. That's part of the reason why the punches are short. Audia putting some good combinations together.
Vivenzi going big, trying to stop Audia here. Lands a big left hook, backs him up and scores again. Vivenzi scoring as we come down to the 1 minute mark of this 10th round.
This fight could very well be on the line, and Vivenzi's been very aggressive here in round 10. He's taken some shots, but he's also thrown a lot of punches.
Audia coming back with some punches of his own.
The uppercut by Barry Audia has been a great weapon for him. Give Barry Audia a lot of credit. Many people felt he might be overmatched in this fight. Despite his record being better than Vivenzi, he has proven absolutely otherwise.
No doubt about it. Good, tough competitor. Smart fighter. Good defensive fighter. He's taking on a tough and aggressive Giovanni Vivenzi. Gets the head to the jaw. His head was snapped back. Vivenzi, unintentional. With the head down, just came up and landed it right on the chin of Audia. 15 seconds to go in the fight.
Audia's doing a lot of hanging on. He may feel, well, I've got this one if I can just survive.
There'll be no knockout. And again, the wild swinging Vivenzi's off balance, but he flurries as we come to the bell ending the fight. Wow. This was a good one. Oh, middleweight night here in Atlantic City. And they've all been good ones. This one goes to the judges. They're on the hot seat now. A good, close fight. We'll be back with a decision in just a moment.
Thursday night, Luis Santana and Felipe.
By a unanimous decision, Giovanni Vivenzi!
Vivenzi built up the early lead. And certainly a big 10th round helped him win the fight. 6-4, 6-4, and 7-3, the scores for Giovanni Vivenzi, who has made it 2 wins in a row in his comeback. A knockout of Kenny Whetstone and a unanimous decision victory over Barry Audia. Disheartened, Barry Audia climbs out of the ring. Giovanni Vivenzi has got to feel good inside, and we will be back to talk with him in just a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Cross. Yes, you can, Barry.
Okay, I want to tell it all. My people back in Pennington Gap and my family vacationing in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. I want to say hello to my girlfriend, Lori, and my friend of mine, Steve, and Knox.
All right. Now, obviously, I thought you performed pretty well tonight. I thought that at the beginning of this fight, you were a little tense, perhaps a little nervous, and about the fourth round, you started to come on a bit. Was that the way it happened?
Well, I was the first few rounds, I wasn't trying to be overly cautious, but I was just trying to box, and I knew the guy could hit hard, and I was just trying to, you know, sort of stay out of harm's way and see what he had.
Did you feel you won the fight?
I want to say no comment on that because I've been gracious in victory, so I want to be gracious in defeat, too. So I just was a close fight, and I wasn't the judge.
Well, indeed, that's graciousness if I've ever seen it. Jay Dudley, your trainer, is here. Jay, was there anything that you felt he could have done that he didn't do tonight?
Yes, if he could have worked harder the 10th round, I believe there'd been no doubt about the fight going his way. Like you said, Al, I thought from the 4th round on, Barry really controlled this fight. He outboxed him in the 7th, 8th, and 9th round. Barry put the pressure on him. And like I said, I felt the 10th round, if we could have won that solid, there would have been no way.
Okay, well, the judges apparently thought otherwise. Congratulations on a good effort, Barry and Jay, and the trip back I'm sure won't be as bad because you did fight well. Okay, let's bring Giovanni Bivenzi in here. Okay, Giovanni, come on in here. There seemed to be, during the course of this fight, as we eavesdropped a little bit in your corner, there seemed to be concern on your part and Carmen's part, and I sensed it too, that you didn't fight as consistently as you did the last time out against Whetstone. Why do you think?
Probably the weight, you know. I really came low, you know, the weight 158 for this fight. And, you know, I won the four rounds, the early four rounds, and then I came strong in the last two, three rounds, and I think that's what pulled it out. But Barry was a very tough competitor. He was on top of me, working, trying his best.
Was he tough to hit? His defense looked excellent tonight.
Yeah, he looked good, you know, but it was just not my night tonight, that's all. You know what I mean?
Let me ask Carmen Graziano. Carmen, one thing you kept telling Giovanni, and I know it was a problem, was he was missing with the right hand because he was stepping before he threw the punch. Why do you think that happened?
His timing was off. He was very lethargic. He started the fight himself. He's saying, I just don't have it tonight. And I tried to psych him. And his timing was off. You can't step and then punch. As you're stepping, the punch would have great velocity. He lost velocity by so doing. However, you know, he pulled it out. It was a very lethargic Bivenzi show tonight. He's a far better fighter, as you've seen in the West. That would be a great rematch. The boy's entitled to a rematch because inside he did a lot of nice things. Good fast punches, good shots.
Okay, would you fight Barry Oddie again?
Sure, I'll give him another chance.
What would you do different next time?
I'll be, you know, more stronger than, you know, tonight. My timing should be, you know, a little better. And I'll box some more, you know, next fight, you know.
Well, in any case, you did enough to win tonight. So Giovanni Bivenzi does get out of here with a win tonight, though maybe not his best performance. Let's go back to Sam Rosen.
Thanks, Al. Congratulations to Giovanni Bivenzi. He wins a unanimous decision over Barry Audia. For Barry Audia, his first defeat as a pro. We will be back with more Top Rank Boxing from Atlantic City in just a moment.
Joint Chiefs of Command, high-ranking sub.